Namaste, I warmly welcome everyone to this virtual science expo. This is Biharini from class 11A and I'm studying in Sbsm Girls Senior Secondary School. The topic of my project is biogas plant. The aim of this project is to show the heat produced with the help of biogas. First, what is biogas? Biogas is a mixture of gases which is produced from the breakdown of organic matters in the absence of oxygen, that is anaerobically. Biogas can also be produced from raw materials like agricultural waste, green waste, food waste and etc. Biogas generally consists of methane and carbon dioxide. In India, biogas is also known as gobar gas. Biogas is a renewable source of energy. Now, let me show the setup of this project. Firstly, I fill the container with cow dung and some vegetable peel. I had put a hole in the cap of this container and made one end of the infusion set to go in. First, biogas can be produced by the anaerobic digestion with the anaerobic organisms which digest materials inside a closed system, or fermentation of biodegradable materials. And this closed system is known as anaerobic digester, biodigester or bioreactor. Biogas is produced for the purpose of generation of heat, electricity and also for the cogeneration of heat and electricity. Let us see the process. After the setup of this project, I had left this for 3 to 4 days so that the gas starts producing. So let's see. First, let's light the candle. The heat coming from the end of the infusion set is the heat produced with the help of biogas. Everyone would have understood the concept of biogas. Thank you.
Hi, I'm K. Bhavna of class 9A. I'm studying in Sbsm Girls Senior Secondary School. I have done a model hand pump. The materials I have used are injection syringe, big size, bikes box, marble, wood stick, small size hose, tire piece. I have taken the syringe. In the syringe, we have a rubber like a substance. I have made 2 holes in it. The rubber will give us a pressure. Then I have taken a small piece of tire and stuck in it with a fabric wick. Now I took the bike spokes and I have cutted the edge. I have cutted it for that makes the screw. So I have cutted it. I have heated the spokes and I have bended it as a curve. After heating it, the extra piece I have cutted it. I have screwed the syringe with a small piece of wood. I have made a hole in the syringe. Now I have taken the spokes and screwed it with the rubber. In another piece of wood, I have made two holes. And I have attached it with the spokes. The hole I have made in the injection, I stuck it with a small piece of hose with hot glue, or you can use Fevikwik also. The hand pump is ready now. We can use it and we can get water from the underground. See, we got lot of water from the hand pump model.
The principle behind the hand pump working. On the upstroke of the piston, the foot valve opens and the suction brings water into the pump head. On the flowing downstroke of the piston, the valve on the piston opens up and allows water to flow above the piston.
The hand pump can bring water up from pretty deep functioning to about 200 feet of synthesis head, but the Bsm pump and 350 feet of synthesis head with the simple pump. The deeper the pump is installed, the more expansion is the installation and the more work pumping the water.
I hope you all have liked this experiment. I thank my teachers and parents who have supported me to do this experiment. I hope you all have liked it. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.
Of 10A from Sbsm Girls Senior Secondary School. I am here to explain how the human excretory system works. It consists of a pair of kidneys, a pair of ureter, a urinary bladder and the urethra. The aorta, which is the largest artery present in our body, supplies the oxygenated blood to the kidneys, and the inferior vena cava takes the deoxygenated blood from the kidneys back to the heart for purification. Now, let us see the filtrational unit of the kidney called the nephron. These nephrons are associated with thin-walled blood capillaries known as the glomerulus. This glomerulus is placed inside the Bowman's capsule where the blood is filtered from the new nitrogenous wastes such as the urea and uric acids. This filtered blood passes through the long tubule where selective reabsorption of glucose, water, salts and amino acids takes place. As the final step, the urine is secreted. The secreted urine from each of the nephrons is collected by the collecting duct and it eventually leads to the ureter. These ureters collect the urine from both of the kidneys and leads to the urinary bladder, where the urine is stored for some time till we find the urge to urinate it out through the urethra. Consider this as the impure blood. When it passes through the kidneys, it gets filtered, urine is secreted and is excreted out through the urethra. Hope you all liked this session. Thank you for giving me this wonderful opportunity in the middle of this pandemic time. Thank you once again.
Respected teacher and my dear friends, a warm good morning to all. I am Joshita RK studying 6C in our school. First of all, I would like to thank my teacher for giving me this opportunity to take part in this science expo and showcase my talent and present it before you on this beautiful day. I can proudly say that this science expo not only helped me but also my friends as well in bringing out our talents. The project that I have took is electric hand sanitizer machine. No doubt that this machine is the need of the heart. I am very much delighted to exhibit the functioning of this machine. As you all know, the world is now struggling against the COVID-19. In the last few months, the one thing we often heard is, clean your hands regularly with soap and water. But soap and water may not be available in every places we visit. So, as an alternate, we are using alcohol-based sanitizer for cleansing our hands. Nowadays, in every places such as hospitals, malls, supermarket and offices are using one or any other method of sanitizer. Generally, we should press the top of the bottle to sanitize our hands, but sometimes we may not use it properly. So it may cause wastage or overusage of sanitizer. This kind of activity prompted me to design an electric hand sanitizer machine. The material required for this machine are cardboard, a 9-volt battery with an attacher, a tool made of ice cream sticks, a submersible pump, a straw, one disposable syringe, a wire, an aluminium foil, a silicone tube, and a disposable container. Take two rectangular pieces of cardboard, four square pieces, and a small rectangular piece to make the structure of the model. A disposable container is used to store the sanitizer. I have made two holes in this container. One hole is used to insert the syringe through which the sanitizer will be poured into the container. The other hole is used to insert the silicone tube. The submersible pump has to be kept inside the container in such a way that the silicone tube is connected to the submersible pump. In the other end of the silicone tube, the straw will be connected, through which the sanitizer will flow into our hands. The submersible pump is used to push the sanitizer through the silicone tube and straw. And a 9-volt battery with an attacher has two wires. One wire is used to connect with the submersible pump, and the other wire is used to connect with the aluminium foil. The aluminium foil is covered with wires is acting as a switch to activate battery and submersible pump. The tool made of ice cream sticks is used to open and close the straw. Now let's see the making of the model. Now connect all the cardboard and stick it using glue and keep the container with sanitizer into the space allotted. We have also made a hole to insert the syringe through which the sanitizer will be poured. I have pasted two aluminium foil by facing each other. When it gets touched, it will activate the battery and submersible pump, which will push in the sanitizer through the silicone tube and straw and throw it in our hands. Now I will explain the working of this model. In the electric hand sanitizer machine, we have to place our hand in the space provided by placing palm side upward, and using the dorsal side of the hand, we have to press the button pad gently once. Immediately, the required amount of sanitizer will flow into our hands. Once the fluid lands in our hands, we have to rub our hands immediately as advised by the doctor. By this method, we can clean our hands quickly. Here, we can avoid overusage or wastage of sanitizer. With this demo, I conclude my presentation. Once again, I would like to thank my teacher for giving me the opportunity to take part in this science expo. Thank you.
Namaste, ma'am. My name is N.S. Gagana Sindhu of 6th F. Today, I am going to show the experiment of bottle and coin pump. For that, we need plastic bottle with cap, coin, scissors and tape. First, remove the cap from the bottle. Put in a hole by the scissors. Like this, and cover the hole by a coin. Same like that, put in a hole in the bottom of the bottle. Like this, and cut in a piece of tape. And fold it into half. and stick it into the bottle. Then close the cap. Take a mug of water and place the bottle inside and squeeze it. Like this, it will automatically come outside. Thank you, ma'am.
All. I am Ricky Gaitri of class 7B. I am here to show my working model. Before showing my working model, I want to say what is a hovercraft. A hovercraft is an air cushion vehicle. It is an amphibious vehicle which can move over land, water, ice and other surfaces. So today we're going to see how to make a hovercraft with the materials at home. So for this we need a balloon, a fabric, a CD, a clip and a bottle cap with a hole at its middle. So let's get started. So with the help of the fabric, stick the bottle cap onto the CD's center. So you can see that the bottle cap has been fixed at the center of it. So leave it some time to be sticked. So we are the next step, we are going to blow a balloon. Don't blow it fully. So now rotate the balloon like this. Then take the cloth clip and put it on it. So next, take the CD and attach the balloon on the CD. So after this, your hovercraft will look like this. So you can see that the balloon has been fixed to the center of the cap and the clip is fixed tightly. So now keep the hovercraft in the middle. Now take out the clip. Check until the hovercraft rotates. So how the hovercraft rotates means the air cushion reduces the friction so the hovercraft moves freely. Thank you.
Hi to one and all, in Street Sunday of class 16. I'm going to show two magics with balloon. Now I'm having a pin. The balloon burst off. The balloon is not bursting because the pressure is distributed among the pins. Now we'll go to the second one. For this, we need a bottle containing vinegar and a balloon containing baking soda. The The balloon is flowing because vinegar is a water which contains 3% of chemical called acetic acid, and the baking soda is a compound of sodium bicarbonate which is called carbonated base. When the vinegar and baking soda combine together, it creates a chemical reaction. Carbon dioxide is formed during the chemical reaction. And thank you.
Hi everyone, I'm S. Monica of class 7B from Sbsm Mota Girls Senior Secondary School. Today I'm going to explain about liquid lift. With the help of a cutter, cut the tops of the bottle. And with the help of a nail, put each hole in the bottle and link them with a plastic straw and seal them with a clay. Now add some water in the bottle. Now I'm going to add little more water in this. Now we'll wait for some time. Now we are able to see, if we pour more water in this bottle, the water goes from the straw goes faster. Now we are able to see the water in both bottles are in the same size. Now take an inflated balloon and gently push them in. Now we are able to see that the water in this bottle goes down and it rises up. Now again I am taking the balloon, it comes to its original position. This is because of air pressure. Thank you all.
Namaste. I'm Ms. Shraddha from class 6E. Now I'm going to show you a model box following command. Let me first show you how the box follows my instructions. Start. Stop. Start. Stop. Start. Stop. Start. Stop. See how it falls and how it stops when I give the command. Come, let us see how to do this model and also learn the science behind. Thick paper, a plastic transparent box, three erasers, and a thread poked into a needle. Let us take the paper and cut in the size of the container's lid. Make a hole exactly at the center of the lid and also in the container. Now fix the three erasers equidistant to each other using cellotape. Now join all the three holes using the thread. Tie gem clips on two corners so that it will be easy to handle. Yes, now our model is ready. You can see an angle passing here. Now, let us see the science behind this. When the string is loosened, it falls freely due to the gravitational pull. When the string is made straight and tight, there is a tension in the string and also that all the three poles do not lie on the straight line. There is an angle formed in the string which gives resistance to the object and hence it stops. I hope you enjoyed this magic. Start. Stop. Start. Stop. Start. Stop. Start. Stop. Start. Stop. I hope you enjoyed this magic again. You have understood the concept behind. Thank you.
explained that air has pressure with the help of water dispenser. A water dispenser is nothing but a bottle fully filled with water and has an outlet at the bottom, which I have used as a straw, and the outlet is not closed. The water dispenser here is made up of cardboard, plastic bottle, straw and a tumbler to collect the water. Even though the outlet is not closed, you can able to notice that the water is not flowing out. How? Let me explain. Anything that needs to move must have some force or pressure on it. Here, when the bottle is fully filled with water, there is no space for the air particles to enter in, and there is insufficient of pressure inside the bottle and the water does not flow out. So if we have also kept the outlet open, the water will not flow out. Now, if I slightly open the cap of the bottle, the water flows out because of the air pressure is increased inside the bottle. And now if I again close the lid of the bottle, the air pressure decreases and the water does not flow out. Now, if I again open the lid of the bottle, the water flows out because of high pressure. Hope you all understood that air has pressure and how a water dispenser works. Thank you.
My warm greetings to all. I'm Ego Sabinam of class 11A from Sbsm Girls Senior Secondary School, and I'm here to explain and demonstrate the function of the heart. One of the primary functions of the heart is to supply blood to body parts, and it also supplies oxygen and nutrients to the tissues and removes waste from the blood. In human circulatory system, the pathway of the blood from heart to lungs and back to the heart is known as pulmonary circulation. And the pathway of the blood from heart to the body parts and back to heart is known as systemic circulation. And these two together make double circulation. The heart contains valves which prevents the blood from backflow. And the heart contains four valves: pulmonary valve, tricuspid valve, mitral valve, aortic valve. And the valves of the heart are made up of three layers: epicardium, myocardium and endocardium. The septum of the heart divides the heart into two sides, right and the left side. And it acts as a barrier between the chamber and helps the heart from preventing the intermixing of deoxygenated and oxygenated blood. The arteries carry oxygenated blood from heart to other parts of the body, and the deoxygenated blood is carried by the veins. The heart contains four chambers: right atrium, right ventricle, left atrium and left ventricle. The deoxygenated blood is supplied to the right atrium from the veins, and it is pumped to the right ventricle. From right ventricle, it is pumped to the lungs, where the lungs purifies the blood into oxygenated blood. The oxygenated blood supplied to left atrium and then to left ventricle, and it is supplied to all the body parts via the arteries. I made this model with the help of two sponge balls, two PVC pipe caps and IV set pipes. I drilled two holes in each pipe cap of size 3 mm and connected the pipes into it, and then connected them with this ball which had a hollow hole in it. Then I covered the balls, each balls, with the balloon which was horizontally cut. And I taped both balls together with red tape and set up my model accordingly. The blockage in the blood flow to our heart muscles is known as myocardiatic infraction, which is also commonly known as heart attack. To prevent this, let's take care of our heart and stay healthy. Thank you.
Hello everyone, this is V. Gunjan Jain of class 10. I have a working model of human respiratory system. I basically took two balloons and attached it to the bottle cap, which is covered by the plastic bottle part. The bottle cap represents the trachea, or also known as the rings of cartilage, and the balloons represent the lungs. It is connected to a straw which ends up in a nasal cavity. It represents the pharynx and the larynx and the pathway through which the oxygen and carbon dioxide travels. Also, I have attached a tube, additional tube, which is not actually necessary, but to show you guys the experiment much briefly and clearly, I have attached it. We have one more main part, which is the diaphragm, placed right below the lungs. Now let me demonstrate it and show to you guys. So now I'm going to blow in some air, which means when it's inhaling. Okay, so when I'm now let's see what happens when I blow in. Did you guys see the lungs? It expanded. Now, did you see the diaphragm too? Let's see again. So, when I blowed in some air, it passed through this tube, then to the straw, which is the pharynx and the larynx, and then to the cap, which is the trachea or the rings of cartilage, and then entered up the balloons, and the balloons got expanded. But why did the diaphragm go downwards? Any idea? It's all because when the balloon expands, it pressurizes the air vacuum surrounding it, and those air vacuum pushes down the diaphragm downwards, and so the diaphragm goes down. Now let's see what happens when I blow out. Blow out in this case means I'm exhaling. Okay, so let's just check it out. You saw that the lungs, from expansion, it got contracted. Now, what happens to the diaphragm? When the diaphragm is downwards, it means we inhale. Now, when I blowed out some air, the diaphragm went upwards. That is to its normal position. When I blowed out, all the air from the balloon came out. And so there is no pressure in the air vacuum surrounding the balloon, and so it will not push up the diaphragm downwards. So this is the exact way our human respiratory system works up. Hope you guys understood it. Thank you.
So first they painted with white color. So I painted one side with adenine and one side with thymine. 80 has two bonds. So then I painted guanine with red color and cytosine with green color. So GC has three bonds, three hydrogen bonds. So we have to stick beads at the ends. So I painted 26 with the respective colors of adenine, thymine, guanine and cytosine.
I took an iron rod. So we have to insert a bead.
And then we have to take a cardboard box, a battery, motor, and some small pieces of wire. So we have to connect the battery with the motor. Then we have to connect this battery with the switch. So our motor is working now. Let's fit this in the cardboard box. So I took some additional thermocol. So I fitted the motor, battery and switch. So then I'm gonna cross the cardboard. I made a hole on its top so that I'm gonna fit the rod here and then the switch is here. So I made a stand of length 40 cm. So then we have to fix this rod. So let's on the motor.
Genes are the blueprint of the life. The three-dimensional structure of DNA was first proposed by James D. Watson and Francis H. Crick in the year 1953, consisting of two long helical strands coiled around a common axis to form a double helix structure. DNA testing became a popular method for identification and research in the year 1985. Hope you are clear with my points. Thank you.
Namaste everyone, I am M. Hasni Sri of class 7F. Today I am going to make a fire extinguisher. So for making the fire extinguisher, let us see the materials required. Some baking soda, some vinegar, a funnel and a bottle. This is a fire with its base, so let's start the process. Let's take a bottle with its funnel. Add some baking soda to it. Now I'm going to add the vinegar to this. This is flooding. So I'll remove this funnel. You are able to see it's forming here. So mix it nicely. Now so guys, you saw that this fire went off. This happens because the fire needs oxygen. When this vinegar and the baking soda mix up, the carbon dioxide is getting released. So this carbon dioxide, when we take near to this, it's forming a thin layer over this fire and the oxygen. So it does not allow the oxygen to support this fire. Thank you. I hope you like this video. Thank you.
Namaste. I am Kavya of Class 10B of Sri Bsm Girls Senior Secondary School. This activity is to demonstrate the electronic configuration of the electrons in an atom. Atomic structure refers to the structure of an atom comprising a nucleus in the center, in which the protons and neutrons are present. The negatively charged particles called electrons revolve around the center of the nucleus. The electronic configuration of an element describes how electrons are distributed in the atomic orbits. So, now this is K, L, M and N shells. In K shells, 2 is the maximum number of electrons and 8 is the maximum number of electrons in L, M and N shells.
Now, hydrogen's atomic number is 1 and it has 1 electron in its K shell. It has 1 electron in its K shell and it has 1 proton in the nucleus. Next, helium has 2 electrons in its K shell. Lithium's atomic number is 3, so it has 3 electrons in total. Beryllium's atomic number is 4 and it has 4 electrons, that is 2 electrons in the K shell and 2 electrons in the L shell. Next, boron's atomic number is 5 and it has 5 electrons. Carbon's atomic number is 6, so it has 6 electrons and 6 protons, so it has 6 electrons. Nitrogen's atomic number is 7, so it has 7 electrons and 7 protons. Oxygen's atomic number is 8, so it has 8 electrons. Fluorine's atomic number is 9, so it has 9 electrons. 2 electrons in the K shell and 7 electrons in the L shell. And it has 9 protons. Now, neon's atomic number is 10. So it has 10 electrons. So we add one another. Now it has 10 electrons and 10 protons. Sodium's atomic number is 11. So now we add one more electron to this and it has 11 electrons. The electrons are 11 and the protons are 11 in sodium. Magnesium has 12 electrons. So we add one another. So it has 12 electrons and 12 protons. In aluminium, the atomic number is 13. So it has 13 electrons and 13 protons. In silicon, atomic number is 14. So it has 14 electrons and 14 protons. In phosphorus, the atomic number is 15. So in phosphorus, it has 15 electrons and 15 protons in the middle. In sulfur, the atomic number is 16, so it has 16 electrons and 16 protons. Then chlorine has 17 electrons. So we add one more electron to this and chlorine has 17 electrons and 17 protons. Next, argon's atomic number is 18. So it has 18 electrons in total. So in argon, there are 18 electrons and 18 protons. Next, in potassium, we have 19 is the atomic number. So we have 19 electrons. So we add one more electron in the N shell. And potassium has 19 electrons and 19 protons. In calcium, the atomic number is 20. So we have 20 electrons in total. So we add one more electron Now we have 20 electrons and 20 protons. This is how electrons are distributed in an atom, and it revolves around the nucleus in its orbits or shells.
Good morning to everybody. My name is Akshaya Kyare of class 60 and I am from Sbsm Girls Senior Secondary School. Today I am going to perform an experiment named as water puzzle. In this experiment we are going to learn about surface tension. Surface tension: the tension of the surface film of a liquid caused by the attraction of the particles in the surface layer by the bulk of the liquid, which tends to the minimized surface area. Now let's start doing this experiment. Before going to this experiment, what are the materials required to do this experiment? A. Color water, a glass, and some coins. Now let's start doing this experiment. Now fill the glass up to the rim. Now let the surface of the water become smooth. Now add coins to the glass of full of water. Why does it not spill? Why does the water not spill? Because a skin prevents water from spilling. And also a top skin vibrates but still holds. And all this because of the surface tension. Let's start counting these coins. It can hold 12 coins. Thank you.
Warm greetings. I am Emma Karishma of 11A from Sbsm School. And here I am going to present you the working model of mobile projector. As we all know that projector is an optical device which projects an image onto a surface. Similarly, mobile projector is a device which projects the digital image of the mobile screen onto a nearby visible surface and amplifies the smaller image. As there are many wonders of science out there around our world, now I am going to talk about one such wonder, namely known as the refraction of light. Refraction. What is refraction? Refraction is the bending of light when it travels from one transparent medium to another due to the change in its speed. Now let me first explain you the procedure. When you notice the shape of the bulb over here, you can see that it slightly bulged outwards. And here it acts as a convex lens. And I have used convex lens in my project because convex lens helps to magnify the image, focus it and appear it sharper on the screen. And I am adding some water inside this to create a denser medium for the light to refract. And I have placed my phone invertedly in front of the lens. Here comes its mechanism. When the light rays from the mobile screen enters into the lens bends the light rays and direction. Due to this change in its direction, the light dispersed and the image appeared larger on the screen. But it is a very well-known fact that light travels in a straight line. Then how did it bend in this case? The main reason behind this is the speed of light. Light travels in different speed in different medium. The speed of light in air is 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second, while the speed of light in water is 2.25 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. When the light travels from the air medium to the water medium, the speed of the light decreases, so the wavelength decreases and the direction changes. As a result, the light disperses and that we obtain a larger image on the screen. Now let's enjoy this magic.
We can see that the lens replicates the bigger version of the mobile on the screen. The brightness and clarity of the image depends on the amount of light being used and the distance between the projector. So place the mobile according to your comfortability. Now all has been set up. Let's adore this appealing view.
Using the cap. Now put two holes on the top of the cap. Now connect the syringe and the thin tube tightly. Then insert the tube in one side of the cap. Make sure that the tube should touch the water.
Now
fill and insert it in the another side of the hole. Now, pull once and push. You can see the water sprays out. Observation: when we pull, the water is coming into the syringe. When we push, it is spraying out. The result is
and purifies it using a dialysis fluid called dialysate. This is the blood pump which gets the purified blood from the dialyzer and pumps into the veins of our body.
Two thin pipes will be inserted into your artery and vein, and one needle will slowly remove blood and transfer it to a machine called a dialyzer or dialysis machine. The dialysis machine is made up of a series of membranes that act as filters and a special liquid called dialysate. The membranes filter waste products from your blood which are passed into the dialysate fluid. The used dialysate fluid is pumped out of the dialyzer and the filtered blood is passed back into your body through the second pipe.
Hope you understand what is hemodialysis. Thanks for giving me such an opportunity during this pandemic time.
Namaste all. I am Lakshmi Ashri of class 9A from Sbsm Girls Senior Secondary School. I am going to explain about the functions of excretory system. The excretory system consists of two kidneys, the right kidney and the left kidney, the ureter, the urinary bladder and urethra. Kidney. The kidneys are beet-shaped organs located on either side of the backbone and are protected by the ribs and muscles of the back. Each human adult kidney has a length of 10 to 12 cm, a width of 5 to 7 cm and weighs around 120 grams to 170 grams. Kidneys filter about half a cup of blood every minute, removing waste and extra water to make urine. The urine flows from the kidneys to the bladder through two thin tubes called ureters. A pair of thin muscular tubes called the ureter comes out of each kidney. It carries urine from the kidney to the urinary bladder. Urinary bladder. It is a muscular sac-like structure which stores urine. Urethra. This tube arises from the urinary bladder and helps to expand urine out of the body. Now I will show you the working model. The blood is filtered through a structural filtration unit called nephron. Each kidney contains a million of nephrons. It is passed through the ureter, it stays in the urinary bladder and it is expelled out of the urethra. Thank you.
Namaste everyone. My name is Sandhya of 7M and today I am going to be preparing a science expo by doing a home projector. Before we go into this experiment, I am going to be telling you what is a projector. It is an output device that is used to project an image onto a large screen such as wall. It is used as an alternative to monitor and television to many people. So, my materials here are smartphone, magnifying glass, shoebox, a blade, scissors, and 4 pieces of tape. So now I am going to start my project. So I am going to take my shoebox and I have cut the middle part and the side part of it. So now I'm going to take the magnifying glass and I'm going to place it and secure it tightly with tape. So now we have completed this part of our project. Now I'm going to take my smartphone. Brightness this much so that it can reflect easily through the magnifying glass. So now I have taken a video. Smartphone upside down so that it can reflect it easily. So now I'm going to turn off my lights and I'm going to show you the result. So now I have turned on my lights and this is my result of my project. This whole project is known as reflection. The light of the smartphone is passing through the magnifying glass and it shows the exact result. And this is my whole part of my project. And I thank my teachers, principal and my coordinators for giving me this opportunity. Thank you. Now,
greetings to all. I am Yuruthika of Class 10A from Sbsm, here to present an experiment on extraction of DNA from bananas at home.
DNA is one of the nucleic acids present in our system. It is a genetic material present in all living organisms. DNA is also the blueprint for our body design. The materials that I am going to be using for today's experiment are as follows.
Liquid soap, rubbing alcohol, ripened bananas, empty jars, water, salt, strainer, plastic spoon and tweezers.
Keep the rubbing alcohol in the freezer for about 30 minutes. Take a glass of water and pour it into a jar. Take 2 spoons of washing liquid. Half a teaspoon of salt. Mix them well. Add the smashed bananas to the mixture and mix them well. Strain the mixture. Pour the mixture into a jar.
1 spoon of rubbing alcohol to the mixture. Leave it undisturbed for a few minutes. A white stringy layer is formed between the mixture and the alcohol. This is the DNA.
The liquid soap that I have used in this experiment causes the cells to pop open, and the salt further breaks the plant cell. This releases the DNA into the solution. The alcohol helps the DNA to precipitate out of the solution.
Hope this experiment was clear. Thank you all.
This is Ramya from Sbsm school and I am studying 6th standard. Today I am going to make an electric swing powered by a battery. This experiment works based on the principle of Fleming left hand rule. Let's begin. The materials we need are 1.5 volt battery, two pencils, any base that will work properly, a doll, a copper rod, a copper wire, and wooden stick. Now, first you have to make a base. In one side of the base, place the battery, and in the other side of the base, stick the magnet. The magnet should be a strong magnet. Now, take the copper rod and copper wire and remove the oxide using sandpaper. To remove the oxide and make it conducting. Attach the ends of the copper wire to both the ends of the rod and leave the other two ends unconnected like this. Now this makes the bottom of the swing. Now we can make the full swing with the help of pencils, wooden stick and hand just above the magnet, and we will connect the other ends of the copper wire to the battery, leaving one end unconnected. And now our swing is ready to work. Now take the unconnected wire. Now take the unconnected wire and keep tapping. It in one end of the battery and the swing starts to rock. Basically, the current is passing through the copper rod and it creates a magnetic field around the copper rod. The field interacts with the magnet and hence get repelled or attracted, causing the rod to get pushed. If you keep the wire connected to the battery for a long time, you will get the force in the same direction, and hence, like you see here, it doesn't swing. So by periodically giving it a torque by tapping the battery, we make our doll swing on the Thank you.
Namaste to everyone. This is Sandhya of class 11A studying in Sbsm Mutagol Senior Secondary School. I am here to present the working model of arms and muscles. Let's see the model. Bone is a hard and non-pliable ground substance rich in calcium salts and collagen fiber which give its strength. Bone anchors the muscle and support main organs of the body. They interact with the skeletal muscles to bring movements. In this model, you can able to observe the tendon which plays the role of balloon and stars in this model. Tendon is a connective tissue which connects muscle to the bones. Tendon is a fibrous tissue
which has great strength but limited flexibility. Muscle contraction results in the interaction between the muscular proteins, the actin and myosin filaments, then generates the movement relating to one another. Binding of myosin to actin filaments helps myosin to function as a motor that drives the filaments line. Let's see the working of this model. For the wonderful opportunity given.
Namaste everyone. I am S. Shreya of class 11A from Sri Bsm Girls Senior Secondary School. Now I am going to explain the working of human digestive system with the help of this model. First, when the food enters the mouth, it gets mashed up with the teeth and mixed up with the saliva and turns into bolus. The saliva contains salivary amylase, which breaks down complex starch into simpler sugar. Then the food enters into the food pipe known as esophagus. The lining of this canal has muscles that rhythmically contract in order to push the food forward. Then this movement is known as peristaltic movement. Then the food enters into the stomach. The walls of the stomach has gastric glands, which releases hydrochloric acid, pepsin and mucus. This hydrochloric acid creates an acidic medium for the stomach so that it facilitates the pepsin to act, and then the mucus protects the inner lining of the stomach. Then the food enters the small intestine, where the complete digestion of carbohydrates, proteins and fats takes place. It also receives the secretion of liver and pancreas. The bile salts break down the larger fat globules into smaller globules. The pancreas releases pancreatic juices, which contains trypsin that digests proteins, and then lipase that breaks down emulsified fats. Then the food enters into the large intestine. Before that, the small intestine contains villi that is has numerous finger-like projections, and it takes the absorbed food to every cell of the body. It also increases the surface area of absorption. Then the food enters into the large intestine, where the walls of the large intestine absorb more water. And then the remaining undigested food gets removed via the anus. Now I'll show the working model. The food enters into the mouth, then to the esophagus, and down to the stomach. Then it travels to the small intestine and large intestine. Then it gets removed by the anus. I hope that you have understood the mechanism behind it. Thank you for watching.
I am N. Shruti of class 7th. From Sri Bsm Girls Senior Secondary School, West Mambalam, Chennai. Today, I am going to make a mini robot.
So, the required materials for making the mini robot is a few ice cream sticks, scissors, a black marker, a bottle cap, glue, a DC motor, and a 9-volt battery with its cap.
Two ice cream sticks on both sides of the battery to give shape to the robot. Now, take two small ice cream stick pieces and stick it in the inner side of the legs. Now, again take two pieces of ice cream stick and stick it for the base of the legs. stick two ice cream sticks on the sides of the battery to make the hands of the robot. Stick the DC motor on top of the battery. Now take a bottle cap and stick it on top of the DC motor to make the face of the robot.
Introduction of class 8. So today we are going to see how does a wind turbine work. First thing that, let's see what is wind energy. Wind is moving air that contains kinetic energy. Wind turbines convert kinetic energy into electricity. Wind turbine's most prominent component are its blades. It usually has two or three blades. Hub and the blades together form the rotor. The main part of the body is nacelle. Inside the nacelle is the heart of turbines, like low-speed shaft, gearbox, high-speed shaft, generator, and wind charge controller. On the top of the nacelle is anemometer, the device which shows wind speed, and wind vane, which shows the wind direction. When the wind hits the blade, they get slipped and rotate around the center. High-speed shaft connected to the generator produces electricity, and the electricity passes and the light works. Wind power is the lowest power available today. Example is Jaisalmer Wind Park located in Rajasthan. Thank you.
Hi, I am Shruti Ramesh of class 60. I am going to demonstrate squeeze and spin experiment. Materials required: 1 fat straw, 1 thin straw, small bead, single punch, stopper, adhesive tape, squeezing bottle with a nozzle, or a pump with a nozzle. Take the fat straw and make the hole at the center with a single punch. Now, seal the sides of the straw with tape. Now you can see that the sides has been sealed completely. Now, with the help of the scissors, nip off the extra tape. Now, cut the triangle with the scissor on one side on one corner. Now cut a triangle on the other side diagonally opposite. Now take the thin straw and cut a triangle on one side. Make sure that you do not cut the other side. Now insert the thin straw inside the hole of the fat straw. Ensure that the hole in the thin straw is within the fat straw. Now take the bead and close the top of the thin straw. Insert the stopper into the thin straw and bring it closer to the spinner. Now insert the thin straw on the nozzle of the bottle. Now squeeze the bottle. Air comes out of the straw. Squeeze the bottle. Air comes out from this straw and is blown out from these holes, and it makes the spin nut to spin.
Mechanical process, the biological process and the chemical process. Now, for an example, I am going to pour this drying water on top of it. And I am pouring the grit chamber. Now, the grit chamber holds the heavy waste, and here the light waste are floating on top of the water. Here the water is collected. 50% of pure water is collected here. And this grit chamber speed of the water is reduced so that sand, grit, pebbles, etc. are settled down. Now here the biological process. I have had some biomes, microbes, and I am covering it with an airtight container. After adding these biomes, I am closing it with a plastic wrap. It should be airtight so that the digestion, here the digestion process is taken. Organic matter is broken down with the help of bacteria. Biogas is produced. Here, next, now I am going to add some chlorine tablets in this chemical process. This is the treated water. Chemicals used to remove phosphorus and nitrogen. Adding chlorine exposure to UV light kills bacteria and disinfects water. This is the 25% clean water. Here the 100% clean water is collected. Now the sewage treatment is completed. This water can be used for watering plants, and it can be used for washing utensils and etc. For drinking, you must boil. For drinking, you must just boil the water and just use it. Thank you.
I'm Sri Sadhana of class 6C. I'm going to do a jumping coin experiment. We have a bottle, a coin and a cold water. Now, I'm going to put the coin as it is in the cold water and the bottle upside down in the cold water. Wait for some time. After some time, take off the bottle from the cold water and the coin. I'm going to place the coin in the top of the bottle, see what is going to happen. Thank you.
all must have seen the jumping of coin. In the beginning of the experiment, the bottle and the air present inside the bottle was cold because of the cold water. When I kept my hands around the body of the bottle, the air present inside the bottle was heated up. This caused the thermal expansion of air molecules. As the air molecules want to come out of the bottle, this is why the coin jumped on the top of the bottle. When there is a more temperature, there would be more pressure. This is the ideal gas law. Thank you for the opportunity.
From Sbsm Girls Senior Secondary School. I am here to explain how the human excretory system works. It consists of a pair of kidneys, a pair of ureter, a urinary bladder and the urethra. The aorta, which is the largest artery present in our body, supplies the oxygenated blood to the kidneys, and the inferior vena cava takes the deoxygenated blood from the kidneys back to the heart for purification. Now, let us see the filtrational unit of the kidney called the nephron. These nephrons are associated with thin-walled blood capillaries known as the glomerulus. This glomerulus is placed inside the Bowman's capsule where the blood is filtered from the new nitrogenous wastes such as the urea and uric acids. This filtered blood passes through the long tubule where selective reabsorption of glucose, water, salts and amino acids takes place. As the final step, the urine is secreted. The secreted urine from each of the nephrons is collected by the collecting duct and it eventually leads to the ureter. These ureters collect the urine from both of the kidneys and leads to the urinary bladder, where the urine is stored for some time till we find the urge to urinate it out through the urethra. Consider this as the impure blood. When it passes through the kidneys, it gets filtered, urine is secreted and is excreted out through the urethra. Hope you all liked this session. Thank you for giving me this wonderful opportunity in the middle of this pandemic time. Thank you once again.
Namaste to all. I am R. Matangi of class 7E. Today, I am going to perform an activity based on acids and bases. Materials required: vinegar, dishwasher soap, tamarind pulp soaked in water, borax solution, baking soda solution, aerated water. Dip one turmeric indicator into baking soda solution and the other into aerated water. Observe the change. One turmeric indicator into dishwasher liquid and one into tamarind water. Observe the changes. Dip one into borax solution and the other into vinegar and observe the change. Observed changes are the BDF turmeric strip change its color into reddish brown or dark red, whereas the ACE turmeric strips did not change its color. Conclusion: turmeric is an acid, so when turmeric comes in contact with acidic substance, it does not change its color, whereas when turmeric indicator comes in contact with basic substance, the color changes. Thank you.
Good morning. This is Pratham of class 9F here to present a model on topic consequences of global warming. So what is global warming? Global warming is the unusual rapid increase in Earth's average surface temperature over the past century, primarily due to the greenhouse gases released as people burn fossil fuels. Due to increase in temperature, glaciers melt rapidly, which causes rise in sea levels and floods low lying areas.
Excess use of vehicles releases lot of harmful gases which causes air pollution. Factories release lot of smoke and the water released from factories goes into the water bodies which gets contaminated and affects living things near it. Deforestation leads to lack of oxygen and affects the animals too. Carbon dioxide and methane are the two main gases which create greenhouse effect. Due to global warming, there is drastic changes in weather and it affects the living things in environment. Thank you.
Hi everyone, this is Kritika B of class 10C of Sbsm Girls Senior Secondary School. I am here to demonstrate a working model of air cooler. First, we have to take a jar and cut a hole and place a plastic part over here. Take the jar lid and connect the DC motor here and insert a fan below the DC motor. Connect the DC motor to the connector and the switch. Place the 9-volt battery here. Stick the switch here and place some ice here. Close the lid. After connecting on the switch, our air cooler is ready. Thank you for giving me such an opportunity during this pandemic time. Thank you.
I'm Tej of class 12B. Here going to present you an experiment of earthquake alarm. Can provide warning of ground shaking during an earthquake. The material required is a buzzer, a switch, a net, a safety pin, a copper wire, 9-volt battery, a cardboard. Take 10 to 10 cardboard and hang a L-shaped cardboard with the help of the cello tape and have a small hole to hold the safety pin firmly. In that safety pin, I have attached a copper wire, the small, with the help of the small hole here, to have the net very, very tightly. The connections are, the one end of the buzzer is attached to the copper wire here. The other end is attached to the switch off here. The 9-volt battery has two connections, red and black. The red is attached to the switch and the black is attached to the copper wire here. And consider this as a earth. When I shake it, the buzzer sounds comes. Let's see it. See, I have the switch here in my hand. You can see here. When I on the switch, see. I'm gonna on the switch here. When I on the switch, the buzzer won't come. Like when there is no kind of a sound here. I have a horn switch here. But I'm offing it. Now I'm on the switch and I'm shaking the cardboard. So you can see. It's now I have the switch. So you can see whenever the earthquake comes, the people can be alerted and they can be moved to the safer place. Thank you.
I'm Vikarunya of Class 6C. Today, I'm going to talk about work and pressure. Air is all around us. The blanket of air which covers the earth is known as atmosphere. The weight of air molecules pressing down is known as air pressure or atmospheric pressure. So first, I'm going to do an activity which shows you that air pressure is all around us. For this activity, the materials are required. It's a bottle, a scissors, a straw, a balloon, tape, and some clay. First, take a straw and insert the balloon inside it and tape it tightly. Insert the balloon inside the bottle's mouth and try blowing the balloon. It's easier to blow the balloon in this way. Now, take some clay and take that clay and close the mouth of the bottle tightly so that air does not get inside the bottle. Now try blowing the balloon again. Spread the balloon by this way, cause the clay blocked the surface of the water bottle so that air pressure did not get inside the balloon. So the balloon does not inflate. Thank you.
Of class 10F of Sri Bsm Girls Senior Secondary School. Today, I am going to explain about soil erosion through a simple experiment. What is soil erosion? Soil erosion is the displacement of the top layer of the soil through various erosive agents like water and wind. So, now let us see the requirements of the experiment.
For this experiment, you will need 6 plastic water bottles, soil, some grass, and some amount of dry leaves known as mulch. Now fill the first plastic bottle with plain soil, second one with soil with a layer of mulch on the top, and the third one with soil along with grass. Now pour the water into the first plastic bottle which has only plain soil. Now pour the water into the second plastic bottle which has soil covered with mulch. Now pour the water into the third plastic bottle which has plants in it. In this project, we have used water as the erosive agent, as water is one of the main erosive agents and it is very destructive one. So, in the first plastic bottle, we have the water we got from the plain soil. As we can see the color of the water, it is very dark brown. In the second bottle, we can see the water we got from the soil covered by mulch and the color of the soil is mild yellow. In the third bottle, we have water we got from the soil which was planted by plants. So, we can see the water color which is very transparent and there is hardly any soil particles. So, by this experiment, we can conclude that soil in the barren land can be easily eroded by water. The water erodes less amount of soil which is covered by mulch and the water hardly erodes any soil which is covered by plants. By this, we can conclude that the best preventive method of preventing soil erosion is by planting more trees, and I recommend you all to plant more trees and prevent soil erosion. Thank you.
Namaste. I am Armi Harni of Class 10B from Sbsm Girls Senior Secondary School. Today, I am going to explain about food chain. Materials required for this project: cardboard, thermocol, chalk and scissors, fevicol, wire, resistor, batteries and LED bulb, sellotape, double sellotape, cotton, cutter, and toys of plants and animals. Food chain is the simple representation of energy flow in nature. Sun is the ultimate source of energy. With the help of sunlight, plants prepare their own food and are called producers. These plants are eaten by herbivores and they are called as primary consumers. These primary consumers are eaten by frog and are called secondary consumers. These secondary consumers are eaten by snake, which are called as tertiary consumers. These tertiary consumers are eaten by eagle. When these plants and animals die, they are decomposed by the microorganisms present in the soil and are converted into nutrients which are again taken by the plants, and the process is called recycling of nutrients. Importance of decomposers: they help in cleaning the environment and in recycling of nutrients. Thank you.
This is Sandhana and Sajana of Class 10B of Sri Bsm Girls Senior Secondary School. Here, we are going to present a project on working model of a heart. So, the materials required for the working model of the heart are water pipes, or we can also use the IV pipes, sellotapes, big balloons, small balloons, two water bottle caps, a spongy ball, scissor, syringe, fevibond, or instead of fevibond we can also use the glues and strings and red color sellotapes. Let's now start with the making of our balls. Now take a small bottle cap and then using the soldered iron we can make a holes, two holes.
Let's now take a smaller water pipe and the balloon and the scissors. Let's now cut the balloon like this. Now, we can insert this small balloon. Let's now take the small pipe and the balloon and then fix it like this. Then we can use this cello tape. Such that the remaining half of the balloon looks like this. Let's now fix it this with the hole of the water pipe. Such that it looks like this. Let's now take a bigger wire and insert it inside the hole of another hole of the water bottle cap like this. Now fix the another balloon with the larger pipe and then pull the pipe outward like this. Let's now take the another syringe connected with the wire and fix it like this and fix it with a glue gun or the Febi bond. Now we have fixed the syringe wire with the bottle cap like this. Now let's take a ball and the cutter and cut it through this like this. Let's take one of the half ball and then cut a small hole like this. Now fix the bottle cap with the ball like this. Now take a balloon and insert inside the ball like this. Now we have made the first part of the heart. And also, here is the second part of the heart. Then we can fix it together like this and we can see how the heart works. Here, the working model of the heart. Then we can see how the heart works.
And this is the working model of the heart. Thank you.
From Sbsm Girls Senior Secondary School. Now I am going to explain that air has pressure with the help of water dispenser. A water dispenser is nothing but a bottle fully filled with water and has an outlet at the bottom, which I have used as a straw, and the outlet is not closed. The water dispenser here is made up of cardboard, plastic bottle, straw and a tumbler to collect the water. Even though the outlet is not closed, you can able to notice that the water is not flowing out. How? Let me explain. Anything that needs to move must have some force or pressure on it. Here, when the bottle is fully filled with water, there is no space for the air particles to enter in and there is insufficient of pressure inside the bottle and the water does not flow out. So, if we have also kept the outlet open, the water will not flow out. Now, if I slightly open the cap of the bottle, the water flows out because of the air pressure is increased inside the bottle. And now if I again close the lid of the bottle, the air pressure decreases and the water does not flow out. Now if I again open the lid of the bottle, the water flows out because of high pressure. Hope you all understood that air has pressure and how a water dispenser works. Thank you.
Namaste. My name is V.S. Tejashwini of Class 8B. Today, I am going to explain about drip irrigation. Drip irrigation is a type of micro irrigation. This system has a potential to save water and nutrition. This system allows by dripping water slowly or either above the soil or below the soil surface.
The goal is to place the water directly to the root zone and minimize evaporation. Thank you.
Hey everyone, I'm Damni, a class 10 student of Sbsm school, and I'm going to display electrolysis of water using pens. Before moving on to the experiment, let me explain the materials required for this demo. A glass of water mixed with salt, a piece of cardboard with two holes, two pencils sharpened at both the ends, a battery connected with wires and switch. Now let's move on to the experiment. Insert the pencils, one in each bowl. Connect the wires with the graphite. Now, as you can see, the wires are connected with the graphite. Now, on the battery. Bubbles started erupting on both the ends of the pencil. The one formed at the positive terminal of the cell is oxygen, while the one formed at the negative terminal of the cell is hydrogen. So this is a process of electrolysis of water, and we have split water into hydrogen and oxygen using pencils. We have used salt water to make the process more faster. Without salt dissolved in water, it would take more time to conduct electricity. Salt dissolves in water, creating ions of its own, thus increasing the amount of flow of electrons and thus making the process much more faster.
Namaste to one and all. I am H. Aparna of class 10A of Sri B.S. Mutha Girls Senior Secondary School, here to present a simple experiment on carbon dioxide extinguishers fire. Let's move on to the experiment. First, let us see the materials needed for the experiment. This is vinegar, a solution of water and acetic acid, a cup, baking soda, chemical name sodium bicarbonate, matchbox, and a candle. First, let us light the candle. Now, Let us mix some baking soda and some vinegar. See, the candle is extinguished. Now we know that carbon dioxide has been evolved during the reaction between vinegar and baking soda. I have written in this equation. You can also check this when during the reaction the bubbles formation is due to carbon dioxide. Now, how was the fire extinguished by carbon dioxide? The carbon dioxide removes the oxygen which is necessary for combustion. Therefore, no oxygen, no combustion, and the fire is extinguished. The same principle is used in soda acid fire extinguishers. In this, sulfuric acid is used instead of vinegar. These both combine when the knob is struck and produce carbon dioxide, which is used to extinguish the fires. I thank all my teachers for giving me this wonderful opportunity. Thank you all for watching this video. Thank you.
Hello everyone, this is Kavya from Sbsm Girl Senior Secondary School, and today I am going to do a water purifier experiment. And these are the materials. There are some type of soil, cotton, impure water, stones, and this is the glass which collect the clear water, and this is the bottle. I have cut at the bottom of the bottle to make it as a purifier. So what I am going to do now is, I am taking the cotton now and keeping inside. And now I'm going to put some stones inside it. No soil. Again, I'm going to put some stones in it. Now I'm pouring the impure water inside it. And we have to wait for some time to get purified water. So after some minutes we got a pure water. Can you see it? We got a pure water. So thank you for the opportunity. Thank you so much.
Hi guys, I'm Sivagami of class 9A. I'm here to present a model on air pressure and water. So before going to the experiment, let us see something. What is pressure? Pressure is the force applied perpendicular to the surface of an object per unit area over which that force is distributed. The SI unit of pressure is called the Pascal. What is air pressure? The definition of air pressure is the force exerted on a surface by the air above it as gravity pulls it to the earth. For example, the air around us has weight and presses against everything it touches. That pressure is called air pressure or atmospheric pressure. Well, do you know the instrument used for measuring atmospheric pressure? Yes, it is barometer, and it is used especially in forecasting the weather and determining altitude. So now let's start the experiment. Aim of the experiment: to show air pressure in water. Materials required: balloon, a plastic bottle with a small mouth, straw, glass and water. Materials required: a bottle, balloons, flexible straw, peg and a glass of water. Now let's start doing it. First take a bottle and make a small hole in it. After that, insert the straw into the bottle by this hole. Ensure that 3/4 of the straw should be inside the bottle and 1/4 should be outside the bottle. After that, fill this bottle with some water. So fill the bottle with water. I have added some color powder to make it interesting. After that, blow a balloon. Blow a balloon and I put a peg so that the air will not escape out, and just put the balloon at the mouth of the bottle. So after fixing the balloon at the mouth of the bottle, and you have to put a peg in that balloon. So after putting the peg, can you see the water coming out? No. Okay, let's see what happens when the peg is removed from the balloon. So the water is coming out, as well as the balloon size is decreasing.
A warm welcome to all. I'm S. Bharati of Class 9A from Sbsm Girls Senior Secondary School. Now, I'm going to demonstrate an experiment on Newton's third law of motion. Before going to the experiment, you would like to know who is Newton? He was a great physicist and mathematician. He developed the principles of modern physics, including the laws of motion, and credited as one of the great minds of scientific revolution. Then, what is third law? It states that every action has an equal and opposite reaction. For better understanding, I am going to demonstrate an experiment. Materials required: one candle, one needle, and two glasses on the same height and matchbox. Procedure: insert the needle. Heat the needle before you insert, which will make it easier to insert it. Now, I'm going to balance it between the pair of the glasses. It's okay that one side is heavier than the other. Last step is to light up the candle. As we light up the candle, it moves in response to the force acting on it, trying to reach equilibrium. If one side of the candle burns more quickly than the other, the lighter side of the candle moves up. The lower side of the candle is angled such that the flame melts the wax, causing it to drip down. This is not only a lesson, the mass at the end of the candle up. This is a Newton's third law, which states for every action there is an equal and opposite reaction. I think you would be understanding Newton's third law well. Thank you.
Namaste to all. I am J. Virashini of Class 11A and from Sri D.S. Mutha Girls Senior Secondary School, and my project topic is ropeway model. You would have seen this type of structure in many of our theme parks. It is used to carry loads or people from one end to other end through this cable or a rope. Some of you have experience also, and even me too. Materials required: a cardboard, a mortar, two nails, a battery, and of course a cable or a thread. I have made two pulleys of equal in diameter, and it is placed on the two pillars, and a rope is between the two pulleys. Motor is connected to the battery to give continuous movement for the rope. Now let's see the working. Now Let's see the physics behind this. Ropeway model is based on the principle of continuous movement. It is a closed system which does not require energy to move its dead weight. Ropeway only require energy to overcome mechanical friction and to move uneven payloads from the uphill and downhill hills. Thank you.
Namaste all. I am S. Mahalakshmi of Class 12B. Today I am here to present my project based on DC motor. DC stands for direct current. So yes, it is a direct current motor. The subtopic of my project is a cutaway of a motor car which moves in the forward and backward direction. Now let me tell a few facts on DC motor. DC motor is a rotating device which is used to convert electrical energy to mechanical energy. Principle behind DC motor is Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, which states that a current carrying conductor experiences a force when placed in a magnetic field. The DC motor is divided into two subdivisions. Number one, brushless direct current motor and brushed direct current motor. Let me make a few comments on brushless direct current motor. They are based on new technology and they are more efficient and they run quieter. Most cars comes with brushless direct current motors. Direct current motors can generate higher torque using powerful currents and they are typically more effective. DC motors are used in the propulsion of electric vehicles. Now, let me tell the materials which I have used to complete this project. A three-way switch, a tap, a cap, a 9-volt battery, ice cream sticks, four caps, connecting wires, a rubber band, a DC motor. Now, let me demonstrate this model. Now, let me explain the switch. Towards my left side, it is in the front direction. If I move the switch towards my right side, then it comes to the backward position. Now, let me demonstrate. First, I will move it to front. I'm stopping here. Now, I will move it back. I'm stopping here. I'll again repeat it. It goes front. I stop it. I'll get it back now. This is how it works. This also has the DC motor and it works in the same principle. Let me tell you few applications where this DC motor is used. It is used in conveyors. It is used in elevators, etc. Thank you.
Hello everyone. So this is N. Sadhna of class 12B from Sri B.S. Muta Girls Senior Secondary School here to perform a model, basically an experiment based on a chemical compound called sodium polyacrylate. So how does this work? The experiment's hypothesis of mine will be the chemical compound called sodium polyacrylate can actually save many lives during the flood by absorbing the water twice or thrice its actual amount. So let's peep into this experiment and prove if my hypothesis is right or wrong. So the materials required for this experiment is a holder, basically a test tube stand, some amount of water, sodium polyacrylate, a test tube, a dropper, and a spoon. Any guess on where I got this sodium polyacrylate compound from? And why is a diaper here? Yes, you got it right. The inner core of the diaper, which is usually called as a magic gel, is actually this compound, which is our hero of the experiment. So let's see the procedure of this experiment.
Here is the procedure. First, I'm gonna take some amount of sodium polyacrylate powder and drop it into the test tube. So I've taken a very less amount of powder. Now I'm gonna drop few drops of water into the test tube and observe. See how the chemical responds to the water.
So here is the observation. This compound has actually reacted with water and got converted into a gel-like structure. I've already added 9 to 10 drops of water and this magical compound absorbed all of those. That's how the gel or the compound looks like after absorbing the water. Now I'm gonna perform this activity for 3 to 4 times and show that it can still absorb a lot of water. So now I have collected the gel after adding so many drops of water into that small amount of sodium polyacrylate. So this is the conclusion. Now if you wonder how to dispose this, wait, there's an advantage for this too. Just by adding this into the soil, your plants are going to grow happily. Now why? Because of its powerful water holding capacity that retains moisture in the soil, and your plant is going to be happy. Thank you.
Warm greetings everyone. My name is Purva Murugan and I would like to display a very simple experiment on the topic hair bone technology. This is used in large industries to remove oil stains from sewage and other industrial effluents. Before we started this experiment, I would like to ask you one question. What happens when we apply oil to our hair? Is the oil dripping down? The answer is no. This is because the hair has the tendency to absorb the oil. And this is the main principle behind the hair bone technology. And now let's see the materials required for this experiment. A water bath or tray, water, hair cut into pieces, you have collected it for 10 to 12 days, two types of oil, sesame oil and coconut oil, socks and a rubber band. Now let's see the procedure for this experiment.
Take a socks and fill it with some hair.
Take a water bath and fill it with some water. Next, put 2 to 3 drops of coconut oil in the water bath. You can see the white drops in the tray. Now, take a socks which is filled with hair and place it in the where you have applied the oil. Place it there for 2 to 3 minutes and you can see what is gonna happen. Remove the socks from the tray. You can see that the oil has been disappeared and the water is really very clear. This experiment can say you that the oil has been removed by the hair which has the tendency to absorb the oil. Now repeat the same experiment with sesame oil also. You can see the oil droplets are floating in and now place the socks in the place where you have dropped the oil. Wait for some time for 2 to 3 minutes and observe the results. Now remove the socks from the place.
You can see that the tray with water is really very clear and the oil droplets have been disappeared.
This is the process which is being carried over even in industries to remove large amounts of oil stains with the help of air. This experiment is a simple way to demonstrate a process which is taking place in a large scale. This is all about this experiment, and I thank you all for watching.
I am Shriya of class 9 from Sbsm Girls Senior Secondary School, and I am here to present a working model on rainwater harvesting. Now I'll show you how I made the model. The materials needed are a big box, then a small box with, in which we are going to fix the motor on it, Then we also need one extra box in case if necessary. Then we need some spray paints in the color of black, brown and green, so we can spray the boxes. Then we also need some cups which acts as a stand for the cardboard. We are going to place the cardboard on top of these cups. And we need a cardboard which I am going to spray paint it green so it looks a bit more natural. Then we need a glue gun, gloves for protection. Then some color papers to wrap the boxes on so it looks neat and good. Then we need a black box with the lid on it. You can see I have put some holes on the lid, so I am going to stick the artificial plants on top of it. So when I pour the water on it, it just drains off in the black box. I'm just going to close the lid on the black box, so when I pour the water, it just drains off in it and does not flow out and damage the project. So next we need is a white box which have connected, which I have put a hole and connected a tube to it and secure the gaps with the glue gun so the water does not flow out. I'm gonna store the water from the clouds on this box. So in this tube, the water from the rain is gonna pass through the tube and it gets collected in the sump. This is why I've connected a tube to it. Then next we need is a cotton in which I'm gonna cut in the shape of the clouds. Then some tapes, a glue bottle, and then some artificial plants which I told before. Then we also need some cars for decoration. So that's all for the materials of this rainwater harvesting. So now let's get to working on the project. So this is the cardboard which I have shown you before. So I have spray painted it green. So you can see I'm gonna fix all the materials and buildings on top of this cardboard only. So here you can see I've covered this box fully with orange color sheets, so it looks neat and nice. So here you can see I've started spray painting this lid black. So after completing this, I'm gonna keep it aside so it can dry and the color turns out good and well. So you can see I've completed decorating this building. So let's move on to the next step. You can see I've cut two holes over here, one for fixing this box and another for fixing this motor sump. You can see I've fixed all these cups below the cardboard. So these cups provide a height and acts as a stand for the cardboard. So you can see I'm fixing the plants on the lid. So when I pour water on them, the water just drains off through the holes and it gets stored on the container below the cardboard, which is placed below the cardboard. This also prevents the water from overflowing on the ground. This is another important material in rainwater harvesting, the mortar. The mortar is fixed to the sump and with the help of this mortar only, the water is sucked through the pipe. So you can see I've completed the building and I've attached a terrace and two black boxes to it. And these both black boxes act as a stand for the rain. So when I'll attach the cloud to the upper black box, and when I put some holes on it and pour water, the water just flows down as rain and the flowing water will get collected in the terrace and then it will flow through the rainwater tube and the another end of the tube will be connected to the sump. So this is the complete outlook of the working model of rainwater harvesting. Now I'll show everything detailedly. First, there's a building and on top of it there's a terrace in which the rainwater is collected and then it's passed through the rainwater pipe and again it's being collected to the rainwater sump where a motor is placed. With the help of the generation of the motor, the rainwater is being sucked through a pipe and where it can be used for various purposes like watering the plants, then washing the cars, then filling the swimming pools, etc. So this rainwater harvesting is very helpful for irrigation and for various domestic purposes also. So an interesting fact about this rainwater harvesting is the groundwater which is left undisturbed can also be stored collected to the sump with the help of the small opening over here if you watch carefully. Now let's test the rainwater harvesting method. So the rain is falling and the water is being collected in the terrace, and then it flows through the rainwater tube, and then it's being collected in the rainwater sump. And as we know, there's a motor placed in rainwater sump. So with the help of the generation of the motor, the rainwater is being sucked from the motor to the tube, and where it can be used for various purposes like watering the plants, then washing the cars, then of filling the swimming pools. So from this we come to know that rainwater harvesting is a very useful method of saving the rainwater. And we also know that none of the water is wasted by using the method of rainwater. So this is the small
So this is the working model of my drone. So I have fitted a container like structure at the bottom, which is also poured. So you could imagine it as a container being fitted under a drone, which is porous, so that the water or pesticides or fertilizer or whatever you want to be spread on the agricultural field can be sprayed through this drone easily. So I've kept a model of these structures for the field. So let us see a working model. Start. So as you can see, okay, done. So basically a drone means you have two parts, which is one is the flying part, the drone, and the next is the remote controller to control it. So there are mainly two things which are doing the work here. So the controller has the transceiver and the drone has the receiver. So the main part of the drone is the controller board. So the controller, a controller board can have many channel tracks, and my controller board in my drone, we have four channel tracks over here. So which controls four individual high RPM motors. So these motors are fixed in a frame which are diagonally opposite from the center, and above each of the motor is fixed a propeller to rotate. So the current flow of these motors are controlled by the controller, which receives the signal from the infrared remote, through the receiver, which is associated with the controller board. So by varying the RPM of the motor, of the four motors, you could achieve the required amount of altitude and direction which you want the drone to be flying. So basically this drone is multi-purposeful. You can either have the drone fly over an agricultural field to spray pesticides or manure, or you can design it in a different way, like having a T-type tube attached to the drone so that water can be sprinkled all over the fields. Or you can also sprinkle the sanitizer in markets. So it is multi-purposeful, these drones. And you can also fix the camera and have an aerial view. You can have the drone is used for multi-purpose. So I have done this with as a basic model. But when you are applying, like when this drone is applied in a reality world to be useful, you could make this drone in a lightweight mode, like using the plastics which are thrown for recycling. So it can be recycled like this and molded into the drone's materials or parts for lightweight. So as the drone becomes lighter, it can easily, like the batteries and motors used for it can be the powers can be reduced, so it can fly for a longer distance or in higher altitude with the lower power, and a lot of goals can be achieved. So hope this was useful. Thank you.
Welcome to Science Expo.
Get ready to watch my model.
Namaste. We are Charuhasini Korea. Now, I will tell you about how to do coin box.
This is my model. Material requirement. Cardboard. Hot glue gun. Scissors. Watching my video.
Good morning friends, I'm K. Akshya of class 11B here to do an experiment on acids, bases and salts. So you can see some materials, right?
So this is a tomato ketchup. These are chalk. This is a soap. This is a liquid hand wash. These are lemon. This is a toothpaste. This is salt. And this is sugar.
So now you want to classify these as acids, bases and salt. So this tomato ketchup is made of tomatoes. So tomato contains oxalic acid. So So I'm gonna keep it in the acid session. And these are citrus fruits. So these contain citric acid. So I'm again gonna keep it in the acid place. And now, what is this? A liquid honey. So it's made of a base. And this is a bar soap and it's made of sodium hydroxide. So these are in the base group. And we also have toothpaste. And even it's made of a base. And now we have salt. Salt. This is sodium chloride. So I'm going to keep it in the salt group. And you know, chalk is also made of a soil and it's calcium carbonate. So I'm going to keep it in the salt group. And this is what sugar. Do you think sugar is an acid or a base or a salt? No, it's none of these. It's neither an acid, neither a base, and neither a salt. So I'm going to keep it separately. So acids have a sour taste. Lemon has a sour taste because of the citric acid present in it. And bases have a bitter taste. It's easy to remember B for bases and B for bitter. And salts, as expected, they have a salty taste. Like sodium chloride has a salty taste. But there are also some salts which are exceptions because they are either sweet or sour or bitter. So now I'm going to talk about the neutralization. What is neutralization? To cancel the effect of. Like an acid cancels the effect of the bitter taste of a base and a base cancels the effect of the sour taste of an acid. So what's a famous chemical reaction in chemistry? That's right. Acid plus base gives salt and water. And of course, a lemon and a soap does not give salt and water. HCl plus NaOH gives NaCl plus H2O. That is hydrochloric acid plus sodium hydroxide gives sodium chloride and water. So now comes identification of acids, bases and salts just by looking at the formula. For example, all acids contains hydrogen. That is HCl, hydrochloric acid, contains hydrogen. But if I give you a statement that all compounds having hydrogen are acids, is it true or false? Of course it's false. Because, like, an example is water, H2O. Even it contains hydrogen, but it's neither acid nor base. It's actually neutral. And also NaOH, which is sodium hydroxide. It's a base, though it contains hydrogen. Another example is sugar. It has the formula C12H22 and O11. Though it has hydrogen, it's not an acid. It doesn't have sour taste, but it's actually sweet. So, for identification, actually, the hydrogen of acids must be replaced. When you add an acid to water, it turns into hydrogen ions. More correctly, it's hydronium ions. The identification of base, it's really simple. Like bases are metal oxides or metal hydroxides or ammonium hydroxide. Ammonium hydroxide is a special mention because ammonium ion is not a metal. Now salts, it's really easy. Salts are formed by the neutralization of an acid and a base. Now, salt should have at least one positive ion other than H plus ion. And it should have at least one negative ion other than oxide or hydroxide ion. Consider NaCl, sodium chloride. It has Na plus ion and Cl minus ion. Now consider another example, ferrous sulfate, FeSO4. FeSO4 has Fe2 plus ion, ferrous, and it also has sulfate ion, which is SO4 2 minus. Now let's look into the solubility of acids, bases and salts. Acids are soluble in water because when acid is dissolved in water, it produces H plus ions, which is hydrogen ions, or more correctly, hydronium ions. Now let's take this example.
I'm going to squeeze it and then stir it. Now we can see it has been completely dissolved.
Bases which are soluble in water are called alkalis. Example, NaOH, that is sodium hydroxide, KOH, potassium hydroxide, and ammonium hydroxide, which is NH4OH. Now let's look into the solubility of salts. There are two types of salts. That is, they are soluble and insoluble. Now we have two salts over here, sodium chloride and calcium carbonate or powdered chalk.
So now let's try to dissolve sodium chloride in water. We can observe that sodium chloride has been dissolved. Now let's try to dissolve calcium carbonate or powdered chalk in water. We can observe that even after continuous stirring, the calcium carbonate or the powdered chalk is not dissolving. So, it's insoluble. We can observe that even after some time, all the sodium chloride has completely dissolved in water. But the powdered chalk or the calcium carbonate has not dissolved in water. And a heap of this salt is at the bottom of the glass. So we can consider that it's insoluble. So now we are going to test whether it's an acid, base or a salt. We have sodium chloride, which is a salt, and we have sodium bicarbonate, which is a base, and we have citric acid, which is an acid. So now I'm going to add blue litmus solution into the acidic medium. You can notice that it has turned pale red. So this shows that blue litmus turns into red when added into an acidic medium. So now I have a base over here. I'm going to add some turmeric to it. And see, I'm going to mix it properly. And I'm also going to add some water to it. You can observe the red color over here. So it says that turmeric turns into red in basic medium. I hope you all liked my video. Thank you.
Hi all. Namaste. This is M. Ketana of class 11B of Sbsm Girls in Secondary School. My project is bottle fountain. It follows the principle of Boyle's law. Boyle's law states that pressure is inversely proportional to volume. That is, when pressure increases, volume decreases. My project is based on that.
Materials required: a bottle, straws, divider or a compass, scissors and gum.
Procedure. Take a divider or compass and make hole in the bottle. Now the hole is ready. Now cut the straw into two. Now take one piece of straw and insert it into the bottle and fasten it with gum. Allow it to dry for some time. Now it is ready. Let's close the opening of the straw and pour water from the top. Don't waste water. Now the bottle is filled with water. When we close the mouth of the bottle and release the straw, the water does not come out. This is due to pressure. When the pressure is not inside the bottle, the water does not come out. When I open the bottle mouth, the water comes out. This is due to pressure. When pressure runs inside the bottle, the water comes out.
When pressure is inserted, volume decreases. This is Boyle's law. Application of Boyle's law is syringe. When the syringe is filled with water and when I insert pressure to it, the water comes out. This is application of Boyle's law. Thank you.
Hi all, Namaste. I am Ketana of class 11B of Sbsm Girls Secondary School. My project is Newton's third law of motion. It states that every action has an equal and an opposite reaction.
Materials required to do my project is a bottle, a balloon, a straw, toothpicks, divider, four bottle caps, cello tape, rubber band and scissors.
Take two toothpicks and fasten it using a cello tape. Now it is ready. Take a divider or a compass and make four holes in the bottle. Now insert the toothpick to inside it. Now, take the compass and make holes on the opposite side to it. Cut it using a scissors. The hole should be bigger enough for the straw to go enter inside it. Now, take the straw and a balloon. Pass the balloon inside the straw and fasten it using a rubber band. Make it tight enough. Make sure when you blow air to the straw, the balloon expands. Now place the straw with balloon inside to the hole which we made in the bottle and pass it out in the mouth of the bottle. Now take four caps and make hole in the center. Now with that cap pass it to the toothpick. Make sure that it does not fall down. If it falls, fasten it with cello tape. Now our project is ready. Now when we blow air through the straw, the balloon expands and when we place it in the ground, the air comes from this side and the bottle moves on the opposite side. This is due to Newton's third law of motion. Now I'm going to demonstrate this project. See, I have blown air in it.
Application of Newton's third law of motion are when a gun is fired and when we row the boat and when we row the boat in the water. Thank you.
Namaste to one and all present here. I'm Sadhana Vijayakumar of class 6A. Today I'm going to demonstrate how to make a cool smartphone amplifier. Materials required: 2 A4 sheets, 2 paper cups, a tape, a scissor, a pencil to mark, and the main thing, smartphone. First, First, take the two papers and roll them as small and tight as you could. This. Now, take the tape to stick it. After you stick it, you get it like this. Now, take the two paper cups. And draw a hole to draw a circle to the diameter of the paper, of the roll. Now, cut this using the scissors. After you cut a hole, you get it like this. Okay? Do the same for the other cup. When you cut a hole, you get it like this. When you cut a hole, be careful and take your parents' help. Okay? Now, take the roll and insert it in the circle you have made in the paper cup, like this. Our amplifier is almost ready. It's going to be so cool when you finish it. And now take your smartphone to measure its size. Using the scissors. When you cut a hole, you get it like this. Okay? To place your smartphone. Now, you have to place your smartphone inside the hole. When you place it, you can play music, enjoy with your family. You have a lot of things to do when you do this thing. Okay? Place this inside. Our amplifier is ready. Now I'm going to demonstrate how to use the amplifier. When you play a song for you. When you place the mobile phone inside the amplifier, you can hear the song more loud and clear. Let me show you. Just a minute. I know you like the song, it's awesome.
There was a little girl, afraid of the big white world.
Can you hear it?
Within her castle walls. Now and then she tried to run, in another night with the setting sun. She went in the subway, so afraid.
It's more louder, see? It was more loud and clear, right? But when you took it out, it was just not that clear and was... Okay? Thank you. I hope you enjoyed the demonstration of the amplifier. You can try this at home. Thank you.
Namaste everyone. Welcome to the Virtual Science Expo. I am S. Pratiksha of 9B studying in Shri B.F. Muttar Girl Senior Secondary School. So I am going to show you a simple fun experiment, balloon rocket. For this, we need a straw, a balloon and a tape and a thread. Now, take a thread and weave a straw in it. Now, take a rope, another end of the thread and tie it somewhere to a hanging. Now, inflate a balloon. Now,
stick the two ends of the straw to the balloon. Do not tie the end of the balloon. Now lift the balloon. Balloon shoots like a rocket. This works on the principle of Newton's third law of motion. For every reaction, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Thank you.
Namaste everyone. This is Shweta Mahesh of 7D. Diwali is a always enjoyable festival for all of us. Last Diwali was very special in Bengaluru, and online jewelry has experimented gold coins dispensing ATM. It accepts money from the users and dispenses gold coins in exchange. As we all know, ATM machinery is based on conveyor belt mechanism widely practiced in manufacturing industries. It will have two or more pulleys to support it. These are classified into two types, horizontal type and inclined type. Here, we have demonstrated inclined cash pushing out mechanism. Let us see the ATM machine in action. This is the place where we insert our cards. This is the place where our gold coins are dispensed. We should enter our PIN and select the amount and click on enter button so that our gold coins are dispensed. And now I am clicking on enter and my gold coins are dispensed. Hope you all enjoyed it. Thank you.
Namaste to everyone. I am Isamina Begum of class 70 from Sri B.S. Mutha Girls Senior Secondary School, Chennai. I am going to explain the theory of Newton's disc with the help of a flywheel. This is a model of a flywheel. It was invented by James Watt. Let me explain what is a Newton's disc. A Newton's disc divided into segments, and each part of a segment is one of the colors found in a rainbow. When we rotate it, the colors fade to white. We can paint the circle with the seven different colors found in a rainbow and sticking it to a flywheel. Even a combination of red, blue and green colors yield the same results. This principle is known as dispersion of light. Dispersion is a phenomenon in which the phase of the velocity of a wave depends on its frequency. Isaac Newton demonstrated that white light is a combination of seven different colors formed in a rainbow. This phenomenon is called persistence of vision. It was a very important discovery as it proved that light is not colorless, but it has color in it, which we together convert to give a faded white color, which we consider as colorless. Hope you have learned something new. Thank you.
Namaste everybody. I am Parthibi of class 9C, and today I am here to do vacuum cleaner using wind power. The required materials to do vacuum cleaner are fan, battery, double-sided tape, motor, plastic bottle, pipe and glue. Today, I am going to start with the fixing of the motor to the fan and the wirings. Let's start. Let me fix to the bottle so that the motor and the fan fixes into the bottle. In the bottom of the motor so that the motor fixes evenly in the bottle. Now let me apply glue in the bottom of the lid so that the lid sits evenly in the bottle. as decorative materials so that my vacuum cleaner looks good. Coming to the top one, I am fixing a pipe in the mouth of the bottle and a nozzle inside the pipe. Now coming to the bottom part again, I'm gonna fix the handle to hold the vacuum cleaner. I'm gonna fix the net so that the net reminds the dust in the top part itself. Now our vacuum cleaner is ready. Let's test whether our vacuum cleaner is working. Now the dust is being remain inside the top part of the vacuum cleaner. Now our vacuum cleaner is ready and working. Thank you everybody for watching.
Namaste to all adults. I am Emmaliti of class 9. I am studying in Sbsm Girls Senior Secondary School. Today I am going to do a physics project on water dispenser. So materials required for water dispenser is cardboard, a small bottle with a straw, and some and two glasses, one with filled water and one empty. So first, remove the cap of the bottle and now catch the other end of the straw, hold it tightly. Now pour some water inside this bottle. Now close the cap. Now the water is not falling. And now if I open the cap slowly, you can see the water coming outside.
Namaste, I am Supraj of class 10C and I am here to represent a pendulum. So the things required are 3 pencils, a marble, thread and double side tapes. With this I am going to make a pendulum. Now I have made the pendulum using the materials mentioned. So first I am sticking these 2 pencils to the bottom. I am also using cello tape to fix it firmly at the bottom, and I am using double side tapes here, and then a thread is fixed to this marble. Now this I have made a pendulum, and you might have also noticed this pendulum somewhere. This pendulum is found in pendulum clocks. Yes, we might have noticed in pendulum clocks this pendulum moves back and forth. In this pendulum, this is called as point of suspension, and this is called the string's actual position is called as its amplitude, and we can measure this pendulum's length from the point of the suspension to the middle of the bob. If the pendulum is the pendulum's one cycle is when it moves back and forth one time, this is one complete cycle of this pendulum. We might also think how does this pendulum oscillate. This pendulum is oscillated when the restoring force acts on the pendulum's mass, so that this pendulum oscillates. So this is how a pendulum works. So Thank you for giving me this opportunity to represent Galileo's pendulum. Thank you once again.
Namaste, I am Arsanjana from class 10F and I will be explaining my project, which consists of two components. One, a simple circuit, and another, a series circuit. The materials required for a simple circuit project is a battery connector, an LED light, a switch, and also some wire. The materials required for the series circuit are 3 DC motors, 3 mechanical fans, some wire, a battery connector, a battery, and a switch. So, as from the name simple circuit, we can understand how simple this circuit is. First, starting at an initial point, we can see that from the battery connector has two wires, one a negative terminal and another a positive terminal. The negative or the positive terminal is connected to the switch directly, whereas another terminal, which is the positive or the negative terminal again, is connected to the LED light with the help of some extra wire. So, as we can see, the circuit is now complete. And now I switch on the light and there we go. The LED light glows magically. This is how the lights in our homes and the fans in our homes work. Moving on, we can see how the series circuit works directly, because the wires have been connected with each other rather than being connected directly with the battery. From the battery, a terminal is being connected with the wire here, and then the same wire gets extended from the DC motor to another motor and also to the last motor, and the other terminal of this side is being connected to the switch. Whereas we can see that the flow of electricity is in one path. There is also another circuit called the parallel circuit, where the flow of electricity is split into two paths. But here in the series circuit, the flow of electricity is in one path. So we can we call it as a series circuit. Now I'll show how it works. I have connected the battery connector to the battery, and now I'm going to switch on the switch. And the fans spin. This is how a series circuit works. Many factories and industries use this type of circuit because the flow of electricity is in one way and therefore can reduce electricity. Thank you.
Greetings to all. I am Veetanushree of class 9B of Sbsm. Here is the model of simple water level indicator alarm, and now I am going to explain about it. What is a water level indicator? Water level circuit alarm is a simple mechanism to detect and indicate the level of water in the overhead tank and also in other containers. Nowadays, all owners are storing the water in the overhead tanks by using pumps. When the water is stored in the tank, no one can identify the level of water and also no one can know when the water tank will fill. Hence, there is an overflow of water in the tank. Thus, there is a wastage of water as well as energy. To resolve this type of problems, water level indicator is used. It helps and indicates the level of water in the overhead tanks. Materials used for this model: small transparent tank, connecting wires, 9-volt battery and its connector, and a small buzzer. Circuit diagram explanation. Here is the circuit diagram of the model. The one end of the battery is connected to one end of the buzzer. The other end of the buzzer is connected to one end of the sensor. The other end of the battery is connected to other end of the sensor. Now, I am going to show you the working of water level indicator. This is a battery and its connector. This is a small buzzer. This is the water tank. And inside the water tank is the water level indicator. As the water level increases, the float attached to the water level indicator rises up. And when the water reaches its maximum level, The float touches the sensor at the top of the water level indicator, and we can observe the alarm made by the buzzer. And now we can understand the working of water level indicator. What is the purpose of water level indicator? The purpose of water level indicator is to guard and manage water levels in the water tank. The control panel can also be programmed to automatically turn on the water pump once the level gets too low and refill the water back to the adequate level. Applications of water level indicator. Water level indicator can be used in hotels, pools, factories, fire protection systems in buildings and many more. Advantage of water level indicator. There are two main advantages of water level indicator. It saves money and power, as well as it works automatically. Thank you so much for giving me such an opportunity.
Hello all. I am Kayuvantika Krishna of Class 6. Today I am going to show you how you can do this amazing trick by making the magnetic top follow a path on the sheet. For making this trick, you need a thin aluminium sheet, steel wire, color wheel on paper, ping pong ball, disc magnet, cutter, cello tape and glue. You can see that the magnet sticks to the GI wire, which is made of iron, but not to the aluminium sheet. This is because magnet gets attracted to things which are made of iron, cobalt, nickel and steel, but not to aluminium. Now you have to bend the GI wire in a curved path and attach it to the aluminium sheet with the help of cellotape. Like this. Now make sure that you turn the sheet so that others cannot see that there is a GI wire hidden in the behind of the sheet. After this attachment, turn the sheet and draw a path on the aluminium sheet. Now with the help of cutter, I am going to cut this ball into two halves. Like this. Now take one half and with the help of glue, attach the magnet inside and the color wheel on paper on the top with the help of glue. Now the top is ready and now we can perform our trick. Keep the top on the drawn path and slowly tilt it. Our trick is ready. Thus, the magnetic top spins and follows the path on the aluminium sheet. It is a very simple trick. The top spins and follows the path only due to the GI wire hidden at the bottom of the aluminium sheet, which our friends will not notice. Thank you.
Namaste to all. I am VSC of class 9C of Sbsm school. I have done a project on neuron First, let me say about neuron. The neuron is a nerve cell and is the primary function unit of the nervous system. These structures extending from the left side of the neuron that look little bit like the branches are called dendrites. Dendrites are the area where neurons receive most of the information. These are receptors or dendrites that are designed to pick up signals from other neurons called neurotransmitters. Those signals picked up by dendrites cause electrical changes in a neuron that are interrupted in an area called the soma or the cell body. The soma contains nucleus, genetic material or of the cell. The soma takes all the information from the axon potential, travels down the axon, which is covered by myelin, an insulatory material that helps to prevent its signal from degrading. The last strip for the axon potential is the axon terminals, also known as synaptic mountains. When the signal reaches the axon terminate, it can cause the release of neurotransmitters. These purple structures represent the dendrites of another neuron. When a neurotransmitter is released from an axon terminate, it reacts with receptors on the dendrites of the next neuron, and the progress repeats with next neuron. Thank you. Cell body, dendrites, nucleus, axon, myelin sheath, Schwann cell, node of Ranvier, axon terminal.